good morning, everyone. Welcome back to Move Daily Fitness. My name is Tracy. All right, this workout today is going to be a shorter total body compound exercise workout. So compound exercises are multi-muscle, multi-joint. They are the best bang for your buck because often you're working upper body and lower body at the same time. It uses the brain, but it also uses a lot of energy. You're gonna require a variety of dumbbells for the workout today. I'll use a box or bench to step up on just for a few exercises, but I'll show you modification if you don't have that. Grab your dumbbells and ready to move daily. Let's do it. All set, strength training on my watch. All right, reach across here. I also didn't say the format, but we're gonna do, because it's a no repeat compound exercise or workout, we're gonna do 1 minute of work, 15 seconds in between, but you're only doing each exercise once, so I just want to stay there a little bit longer just to make sure we, you know, hit it hard. All right, so 60 and 15. All right, let's go into squat. Reach here overhead. Two more here. All right, let's take it wide, stretch in the chest. Last two here, stay in this position. We're gonna do a nice gentle rock side to side, drop your shoulder towards your opposite knee. Round through that lower back a bit, warm it up. Always a good thing to do. You've been sitting all morning or sleeping all night. Just wanna make sure everything's good before we do compound exercises. Since you really need your core when you're doing these. Okay, let's do some knee grabs. Alternating here. Oh, it feels good on the inner thigh. A couple more. And last one here. Let's grab. Oh, shoulder circles. Tap it out. Switch directions. Good, and take it wide, lift into your toes. Last two. And we'll stay wide for a nice torso twist here. Reach those elbows across. Last two here. All right, are you ready to start? Here's your first five exercises. Let's go. We're gonna start with a side lunge press. I've got my 12-pound dumbbell. Lunging to the side, hips back, and then we're gonna press at the top. I will call halfway and we'll switch sides. All right, here we go. Reach and press. Really think of that one bent leg as doing a squat, okay? That's how far back you want that hip. Last one here. All right, take a step, switch sides, and work. All right, I'm grabbing 10s for my King Kong. It's a squat curl press combo. Wide stance, feet face the front. And drop in the center, curl, press, neutral grip. Low, and here we go. Your core engaged, especially as you do those overhead presses. You want to kind of squeeze the abs. Nice and tall press. All right. I'm going to stick with a 12-pound dumbbell for my squat halo high knee. So you hold the dumbbell here, you'll squat, elbow to knee, halo, then squat, switch sides. All right, squat, elbow to knee, halo, and squat, elbow to knee, halo. Good. Squat, knee, halo. Get those elbows up high for the halo part, right around the head. Nice, I'm gonna grab my other 12 for the deadlift upright row combo. All right, knees are soft. Hinge at the waist, full stand, and then your row. Here we go. Slow and stand, pull. Here. I'm going to hold my 12s. We're going to do an alternating reverse lunge with a palm up bicep curl at the top. Palms face the ceiling on this one, okay? And alternating your legs. Core tight and work. Take it back and curl, switch legs. Your elbows tucked in here. I'm gonna do a
squat, single side thrust. Okay, so squat together, single side at the top. Let's stick with my 12s here. Just because of the volume, it'll be high. Get shoulder width. Here we go. Drop it low, single side here. Now switch. Good. This one's getting heart rate up. One more here. All right, I'm grabbing an 8 for my squat, reverse lunge press combo. Squat in the center, front press, reverse lunge, front press. Okay, alternating sides, and squat, press, reverse, press, switch legs, press, reverse, press. Diagonal. Low. I'll call half. Switch sides. Should be a nice flip of the elbow there and the wrist. That one down. Alternating front lunge with a twist press. I'll use an 8. You're gonna take it forward toward the bent leg. You'll turn and press. All right, we alternate here. So down, turn, press. Push it up, switch legs. Down, turn, press. Ground next for a few. I'm gonna bring my 15s down there. Alright, you're starting with your tricep press, shallow overhead extension. Again, I've got 15s, maybe 12s, whatever. You can overhead tricep, palms facing, you're up, down to the ground, shallow overhead, return, up, down, shallow, and return at the hips, down, shallow, return. When everything is up, you put your hips up. I'm gonna do a partial Turkish get up next. I'll hold 115. That is a really heavy weight, so feel free to lighten if you need. I'm not doing the full Turkish. Just the sit-up portion to hips up. Not as hard. All right, set weight, one weight down. I'm holding the 15. Whatever arm my hand is holding the dumbbell, that's the knee that's bent. Other hand is to the side. You sit up, head behind, hips up, I'll call half. All right. Lay down, up, hip, there we go. Hold that arm straight above you. Don't drop the dumbbell. All right, switch arms and legs. Here we go. Down here for your up down plank bear hop. Woohoo! That was heavy. Okay, elbow, hand for your up down plank. Then you're gonna hop into bear right here or walk. Mod up down from the knees. So elbow, hand, bear, return. Down. This is hard for a minute. All right, flip it over. Crush grip. Press to overhead tricep. Crush grip means the dumbbells touch. All right. I'm using 15s. Press it up, overhead tricep, up, bring to the chest. My dumbbells are touching the entire time. I'm just being very cautious of my skull. Slow control. Feeling that now on the triceps for sure. These 15s are heavy. Crush grip uses a bit more tries. There you go. Okay, Take a break if you need a little water. Join me for the second half. I'm gonna start with a step up reverse lunge combo. To mod, you can do a squat, reverse, stay on the same side until I call half. I'm just gonna hold 10s. All right, same side for 30 seconds. Step up, step down, reverse. Same side, up, tap, down, reverse. Make note of what foot is stepping up, then we'll switch at the half. All right, switch your leg. We're gonna do a sit squat press coming up. You can turn that just into a wide stance squat press if you don't have a chair or bench to sit on here. All right, I'm gonna grab 12s. Wide stance, weights are at your shoulders. Gonna stand and press, don't plop down. Up, press, control. All right, you don't wanna plop your body. The control is part of that eccentric recruitment of your muscles there. You can feel your core more too. Shoulders. Okay, we're gonna do an alternating step up front raise. If you don't have the bench, your squat, alternating high knee front raise. I'm gonna grab my eights, alternating that step up. Shoulders back, here we go. So step, raise at the top. Down, down, other side. Raise. Down, down. My palms start facing my legs and then turn down at the top. All right, stationary lunge, fly. Whew. I think I'm just gonna pull fives. I'll call halfway on the lunge. One in front, one behind. Up and down, low and squeeze. Open together, good. All right, switch legs. Here we go, and low. Whew. Shoulders are on fire. Doesn't take much. Nice. All right, single leg deadlift or staggered deadlift to a high pull. I'm gonna hold a 15. So I'm holding in my right leg is ahead, left toe, tiptoe, same side for 30. So you're low, stand, pull. And low, stand, pull, elbow high, right, up higher than your wrist. In the front view. Hip back and up. All right, switch legs and hands, tiptoe, hinge and front squat. Arnold is next. I'll grab my 10s for that. Squat position, feet are just shoulder width. This is an ass to grass squat, as low as you can go. Hopefully your elbows get down to your knees if you have that range of motion. Drop, stand, Arnold there, bring it back here, and press. I'm gonna use 112 for my plie skull crusher move. You can hold it this way or this way, whatever you prefer. Take it wide, everything down, then up. Low, press at the top, have a good handle on that dumbbell. Medial delts. Feel this one too. All right. You're gonna do a squat bicep curl reverse grip press. I think I'll hold 10s there. I'm gonna squat wide again, just like this. Toes are out. So squat, curl, reverse grip right there. Keep your elbows nice and close to your body. Watch your chin on the press. Little weighted princess sit up is next. I'll just grab a 5 for that. Last here. comma. Okay, take it down to the ground. 1, 5. You'll stay on the same side for 30 seconds, then we'll switch. One knee is bent, one leg is straight. Dumbbell touches the toe. And you're up. Same side. Off the mat. One more here, switch your side. More. Mama. Woo. Okay, last exercise. We're gonna hit the ultimate deadlift. I'm gonna use 12s. It's a squat. It's a deadlift, high pull, squat, curl press. There's the 5 exercises. All right, deadlift first. Deadlift, high pull here, squat, curl, press. Deadlift, reach your hips, high pull. You have to have nice narrow stance here for this one. I love this one. You do too, don't you? Anyway. Seconds. Let's go. Gonna get another round in here. In 3, 2, 1, done. Perfect. Give them daily. In your 30-minute compound blast. That was great. I feel sweaty. Muscles feel worked. Enjoy for a stretch if you can. All right. I got my bench here. I'm gonna use it for stretch. Heel up. You can put it on a chair or on the floor even. Hinge forward at the waist. Knee is soft. Stretch that hamstring. That was good. Yeah, it's good. I did a jumping, hopping workout yesterday, so I needed something stationary and short. I was fatigued today, but I wanted to do something. For me, this is perfect. And the 1 minute intervals means, can you do it for that long? Yes, you can. Then you don't have to come back to that one. I like that mentally if I'm fatigued as well. It's easy, it's a good flow for me. In our membership right now, this next week coming up, we're talking about gut health. I'm like, that's my bandwagon right now, because what I'm reading about it and the people who are posting about it, you know, doctors, scientists, people who study this, is that it's just so critical to reduce inflammation in the body for other, you know, functions of the body to function at their maximum. Reduced inflammation is a must. And when we eat foods that are high in fiber, when we eat foods that are probiotic or fermented, they have good bacteria that can help build the ecosystem, let's go side to side here, in our gut. And that's what makes it flourish, that's what reduces inflammation, that's what prevents the gut from leaking, that's what gives it food to build good microbiota down there. So. Yeah, we're talking this week about probiotics. Should you or shouldn't you? There's lots of camps that, you know, have differing opinions, and it's interesting to read some of the journals and abstracts that I've been looking at. But everyone is a full bore in agreement on fermented foods. So things like sauerkraut, kefir, yogurt, some sour creams, kimchi, kombucha. There's lots of different foods that you can make even yourself. Things like fermented salsa are pretty simple to make. You just, well, follow directions, but you can just leave it on the counter and it ferments.
My client used to make that all the time and give me some. I'm like, why is this fizzing on my tongue? Is that right? Should it be like that? But if you follow the proper protocol, you can make your own fermented foods too that will increase your gut microbiome, which will make the rest of your body healthy. So I'm all for it. I'm doing the most I can this fall. That's my thing I'm doing that I'm working on, is seeing how much fiber I can get in my diet just to help with menopause belly and just to stay as healthy as I can. All right, thanks for joining. I hope you go move daily in your fitness, wellness, and nutrition. If you want to join our membership and hear conversations like that and coaching calls like that, click or tap the screen right there. And for more compound workouts, click or tap right there. See ya in the next workout.